So we've just had Blair appearing at the Iraq inquiry. It's not a legal binding one. It's just another chat. They've had these chats, these inquiries, but they're like, they're on that edge of the whole subject, or they're on that edge, or on that star out there, on that moon, but never the whole subject. It is dodged, avoided. And, you know, we'll have a talk about that bloke or that bloke. So there's a lot of dodging been going on. The people wanted a big public judicial inquiry, but they got this, and Blair's appeared, and he said, basically, that he's acted like a president. He's not a president. He's the first minister. We have in this country a first minister, and they have to confide in others, like other MPs, lawyers, that sort of thing. If you don't, you're more like a president. And that's all right. If you want to act like a president, that's fine. But you've got to go through a process and try and make yourself a president. You don't just seize power. That's called dictatorship. And when you go and kill a lot of people, that's called dictatorship, mass murderer. And we're getting on to like Hitler thing. You just sort of seize power and take over and kill a lot of people. That's the Hitler stance. We got a thingy called First Minister, and they're supposed to take advice, and he says, I have taken advice. And it's sort of advice, come, I'll bully people. I got my way. So many lawyers said it was illegal to go to a war with Iraq. But there's this one, Goldsmith, and he also said it's illegal. But they took him off to America. I don't know. Guantanamo Bay, I don't know. But he's come back. It's all turned around, waterboarded him, and he says, yes, I now agree. Well, they had the UN resolution, they said, we're going to go by an old resolution. But that's against the spirit, because they tried to go for another resolution, and they didn't get it. The other countries said, no, we're not going to let you go to war. So Blair knew the UN was against him going to war. But he said, oh, the previous version allows me to. Well, that's not in the spirit, is it? You know full well, they said, no, don't go to war. We're not allowing you. We're not giving our sanction for it. So he knew. So he was going against them. And all that, oh, I'm doing what they allowed me to do is rubbish, because he knew. At that point, he was actually going against them, because he knew that they didn't want him to go to war. That's a lie. And then he persuaded the House of Commons that he was allowed to go to war because of WMD. It's a threat to Britain. How is this a threat to Britain? Our forces in Cyprus, apparently. But that was bogus, because they couldn't hit the Cyprus troops. But then his other stance was now that the terrorists could have got hold of Iraq's stuff. Well, that's pointless, because Iraq didn't have any stuff to get hold of. And all that Nigerian stuff was made up. So it's all on, they might do this and they might do that. And there's other countries around the world at worse state than this, Pakistan, Iran, or rather, you know, that Iran's got actual weapons, and Pakistan's getting close to being taken over by terrorists. All other countries more like on the limit than Iraq. And there's other countries that do mass murder, like the Kurds issue. But we haven't invaded them. This is called regime change. And they're not a threat to Britain. It just don't qualify anyway. But this is what makes Blair a bit of a warmonger, really. For some reason, he wanted to be joined at the hip with America. And while in America, there's all like, this is getting our payback for, this is Iraq payback for 9/11. Over here, in Gulf Blighty, we knew that there was actually a bunch of Saudis that did it, and Al-Qaeda, and then not the Saddam mob, who was like more secular and anti that sort of religion and fanatics. He liked to keep these people quiet, by any means. And he wasn't into that sort of disturbances, he wouldn't allow it. So that's why it all looked a bit odd in this country. And that's why we've got the Iraqi inquiry.